so she's cabin up in Beacon. And to meet his daughters and, you know, go hang out, get acquainted. And Pete was driving me in his little red VW. And as we were pulling out the driveway, I think he's got the radio on, and he looked over at me and says, "So, guy, what kind of music do you like?" And I looked over at him as if he were some sort of archaic figure that they just brought out of the Egyptian pyramids, you know, in a tomb. And I said, "James Brown," as if to say, like, "You ever heard of him, old man?" You know, and I was just snarky little snothead kid. I mean, even though I did love folk music very much, you know, I just wanted him, and the whole world to know that I was into whatever I, you know, could get that made me hip. And James Brown wasn't getting played much in our house. I was like, "James Brown." And Pete, a very understanding guy, as beautiful and filled with music as he was, you always got the feeling that there was room for you in the room with him, you know, that he wasn't trying to be all over everything, that everything in the world wasn't about music, his music, this music. It was about people. And when he was with you, it was about you. So I remember that very much about Pete. James Brown.
I got soul, and I'm super bad. I'm love. I love to do my thing. And I don't need no one else.
Blues America. America. Blues America.
America.
Let the good times roll.
Now, if you play it so they don't understand the words, they like it. But if you got to listen to the words and listen to what a real blues singer is saying, and he's singing out his feelings, well, no, they don't care for it. Well, they're trying to get their mind off of what happened years ago. They don't want to go into the past. They want to go into the future. Well, I came here in the past, so I'm still just the same way as I always was. They'll come back. They'll finally come back down to this. But it may be in a different form, but it'd be the same thing that I'm doing now. It'll come back.
You're listening to Blues America.
Blues America. Blues
America. When the songs I sing turn to ashes on my tongue, when I look in the mirror, see that I'm no longer young. Then I gotta start the job of separating false from true.
You're listening to Blues America. I'm your host, Drew Verbis, and I'm hanging out with today's special guest on the studio phone, Guy Davis. We were just talking about Pete Seeger, and the music bed right now is featuring Guy performing False from True, a wonderful tribute cover. The original was recorded by Pete on the album At 89, which won a Grammy, I think. Of course, I don't have an official fact checker on this program, so you'll just have to take my word for it. Guy, let's mention your acting career. I think most of your fans know that you've worked on movie, film, TV, and Broadway. Are you still acting?
Not right this moment, but from time to time, I do my play called The Adventures of Fishy Waters in Bed with the Blues. And I did it a couple of years ago, in almost 2-week run down in New Brunswick, New Jersey. I did it at the educational branch of Lincoln Center in New York City. I have done it as far away as Australia. So I can't say that I'm not doing it. It just has not been very active that I've done it. But the most outstanding stage work that I got to do was back in 2009 on Broadway, when I got to play the harmonica in Finian's Rainbow and do the role that Sonny Terry had back in the 1940s. And I loved that.
Now, I think your contributions to the blues have been amazing. What do you think about Guy Davis, the blues legend?
I'm anything but a legendary blues musician. I think I'm a good musician, a damn good blues musician and entertainer and storyteller. The legendary. I think that's a super PR word. And I don't know, maybe when you want an award, I guess you want the world to know you're legendary and all that sort of thing.
Guy, I've been to a few of your shows. They were all solo performances, and I really love them because I feel the audience really has to listen and show respect to the blues as sort of an art form, if that makes sense. My question is, do you have a preference to perform solo or with a band?
I guess if I had to boil it down, the only one thing I would love to do is solo, because I get to tell all the stories I want, and I get to perform in, what would I say, sort of an itinerant manner. I'm more mobile. I could sing outdoors, indoors, in a park, in a school, in a church. I do love performing with a band, though, and from time to time it's a good thing. It gives you a different kind of power, a fuller musical presentation, and it can move people in a way that a solo performer rarely can move people. So I love both, but if I had to only choose one, I think I could choose solo performance.
Now, you've given us some many great records, something like 13 solo albums. We don't have time to talk about all of them. Do you have a favorite?
I do have favorite things about various albums, but I'm going to stick with this latest one, Kokomo Kidd, as being my number one favorite, because I think I'm kind of a work of evolution. And maybe as I progress, I think my work gets better. And it's not just that. I mean, I'm writing and doing stuff that I really like, that I really love. I will say, though, that I think on my Give In Kind CD from more than 10 years ago, I did a version of Big Bill Brunzi's Good Liquor Is Gonna Carry Me Down. That doesn't necessarily make it my favorite CD, but it is amongst one of my favorite cuts on a CD.
Is it hard to translate the live energy of a concert onto a studio recording?
Yes, it is hard to translate translate onto a CD the stuff that I do live. There's a spontaneity and energy in a live performance that I think it's very difficult to capture on a studio-made CD. I'm not saying it can't be done. But I just have to do the best I can and hope that the quality of the song raises people's eyes, ears, minds, hearts, and souls up, you know, and allows them to hear the magic that I hear as I present it.
Someday I'm gonna tell her to stop her crying. She has to move on instead of laying here dying. Got reasons besides kids to keep on living, and a love worth having is a love worth giving.
Guy Davis, it's been a pleasure to speak to you. Thank you for being on Blues America. And if I haven't mentioned it already, congratulations on your recent Blues Music Award nomination. Links to your website are available at bluesamerica.com. And if you'd like to add anything else, I'll give you the last word.
Yes, I would like to say this. Although, like anyone, I get excited at the prospect of perhaps winning an award
for recognition of the music that I have performed and produced. I feel close and happy for all the people in our industry, especially my brother Eric Bibb, whose dad Leon Bibb died earlier this year. Somebody I had known who was a contemporary of my folks, but somebody I, you know, began to call Uncle Leon after a while. So I would just like to say that it's being part of this blues family that excites me the most. And if some recognition comes in terms of an award, good. But if, say, Eric were to get this, I would be ecstatic. And there are other folks being nominated in various categories. I wish us all the best, all of us. There's room for all of us. Doggone it, there's work for everybody.
Okay, thanks, God. Take care.
All right, you take care.
Blues America is endorsed by the Phoenix Blues Society. Learn how to become a member at phoenixblues.org.
It's time to go back, baby. Way, way back. This is the Way, Way Back Blues.
Listen, Mr. Khrushchev, I heard a lot of talk about the satellite missile and the president's fault. You better listen to what I gotta say. Things I'm gonna tell gonna make you hot, turn gray. I got a satellite, baby, with a red hot style that's new. Well, she got more speed than Sputnik number two. You talk about your Sputnik and your hound dog crew. I got a rocket, baby, faster than the Asiatic flu. I got a satellite, baby, with a red hot style that's new. Well, you got more speed than Sputnik number two. Sputnik and your hound dog crew. I got that rocket, baby, faster than the